in his eyes, an our familiar longing, flecks of brown and gold. It's hard to say. His gaze wanders southwest, down the street that goes beyond the horizon.
Excuse me?
A flinch jolts his frame. The question has touched a nerve.
Man, I don't know what to say. Not much anyone can do. There's no helping in absence, you know? I miss my family. They're all I have. My wife, second kid on the way, waiting all the way in Diora. And here I am stuck in this shit, so far from home. Diora of the Seven Seas. It's on the other end of Le Caillou, pretty much, on another island called Laurentide, off mainland. We've got a little place there. Can almost hear my kid laugh when it snows. What's it like? Good. And bad. An ache that brings you joy. I think of them a lot. I dream up these silly scenarios in great detail of living with them. It comforts me. What about you, Copman? You missing someone? I feel for you, my friend. It's bad enough to know who you miss. Missing like that doesn't feel like it has much of an upside. But, thanks for this. It's nice to talk to someone, and I know it wasn't easy to ask. I hope you find your way through your own troubles.
You hold in your hand the colorful primer. The title reads, "A Primer for Small Kids." There's a bear involved. This book will show you the score. Get you oriented with those basic concepts you appear to be hazy on. The anthropomorphic bear will give you the lowdown of your life. The alphabet. Every page has one word designating one letter of the alphabet with a faded illustration. Most of them are scientific and cultural principles. It goes as follows. A is for azimuth. B is for boreas. C is for cosine. D is for diamite. E is for ellipse. F is for phlogiston. G is for gamut. H is for homeboy. I is for econ. J is for Eura. K is for collapse. L is for laudanum. M is for myriad. N is for nadir. O is for aureole. P is for perihelion. Q is for quasar. R is for rhododendron. S is for sinus. T is for tricolor. U is for ultra. V is for vector. W is for varheit. X is for xylophone. Y is for ustava. Z is for zenith. That's it. You know the alphabet now.
Aye, the sea's gonna calm down soon. I can feel it. The wind is turning southeast. What's on your mind, officer? Oh, that's good to know, I guess. Why is it in the sea? An installation. Us poor people are stupid and don't get installations. All I see is a heap of trash. This actually calls for a funeral, I think. Aye. Feels deserved, don't you think? Falling in the line of duty like that and all. Quite odd. Our things are a part of our life world. They're made with our human sweat and they share human history. We should care about them as we care about humans. To some extent, at least.
Life world. Someone's been reading up on last century Gottwaldian philosophers. Play it cool now.
Oh yeah? You won't even be able to get it out of the water before early June. And where are you going to bury it? Who to invite? What music to play at the wake? Take it from someone who's been through a few funerals. It's easiest to just leave them there and let nature take care of it.
It's going to be quite a few years before nature is able to completely take care of a motor carriage. You could always come back in a few months and see if you still want to give it a proper send-off.
I understand, believe me. I really do. I think about all the frivolous side activities I could be doing every time I go out there with my nets. But daydreaming is a rich man's game. At sea, you can't afford to be careless and dream. Anyway, what are we talking about here again?
Softly, light brown eyes look back at you, directly into the space behind your eye sockets. You see the smoke rise from between her painted red lips. She's beautiful. I have bad news for you. You know these guys?
Who? Me?
Yes, he's talking about you, you shifty asshole. You too.
Me? No way. I'm straight, man.
These guys are compromised. She's got them singing along to her tune. The little bleeps and bloops you trust for info, you can't trust them anymore. Believe it. There's no way of knowing. At the moment, I'm afraid it's best to assume. All of them. How it always does, through subtlety. There's nothing you can do about it. You are how you are, and she is how she is. Things will go as they do. No. It's better to know you're being played than to be played without knowing it, is it not? Yes. Mr. Thespian here has been singing paeans to how truthful she is.
She is a lady, most fair and just.
In his defense, to reduce him to such inadequacy, she probably had to employ half-truths more often than outright lies.
That is correct. And omissions, too.
A little. They're all still of limited use, interpreting things to the best of their ability. Maybe they add flair or something. I wouldn't know. I don't add flair. But when it comes to assessments of character and factual accuracy, they are not to be trusted. Not with her. Don't be melodramatic. You can trust them. Just not with her.
A light green speck and imperfection on the outer rim of her right iris. It sparkles. Rise and shine, comrade. It's time to get to work. Despite all the thinking you've been doing, only 0.0001% of communism has been built. It's too great a task to undertake alone. You're going to have to get organized. It's good that your personal business is in order, but we're talking about political matters of world historical import here. You must seek out your revolutionary brothers and sisters. Find out how much communism they've built. Then, together, maybe you'll be able to build as much as 0.0002% of communism. But it won't be easy. Decades of persecution by coalition authorities have driven the remaining communists of Martinez underground. Just between us, you may want to lay off this grind up the bourgeoisie stuff. It's a bit off-putting, even to fellow communists. Let your nose guide you, detective. Yes, fortunately, communists are known to have a very distinct smell. We really have no idea what they're talking about. There's no linkage between ideology and olfaction. First, you'll have to locate the remaining communists in Martinez. When you get near to someone with revolutionary potential, your nose will give you the signal to establish contact. Again, no, it won't. Any olfactory response you perceive will be strictly psychosomatic. Judging from the bust of Krasmazov and other revolutionary paraphernalia you discovered, it seems that the Cape Side apartments may be a hotbed of communist activity. You'll discuss the monumental world historical task that lies before you. You'll engage in rigorous and spirited debates about Mazovian theory and practice. But mostly, you'll probably complain about other communists. Not at all. Complaining about other communists is one of the most important parts of being a communist. Here we go. Wake, brave worker. 'Tis no time for bed. Fight till there's no slaves below and no masters overhead. She's whistling a melody, her trusty contact mic attached to a wooden pulpit. At the sound of your footsteps, she stops what she was doing and turns to you. That melody is oddly familiar. Why does it feel like some gang-related thing?
Hey there. I've been recording some new audio from all these beams and rafters. The sounds travelling through the wood are pretty cool. Creaks and stuff. Like you're underwater, you know? But like, underwater inside a tree. But that's not really what I wanted to talk about. I wanted to thank you instead. For getting me and my friends in here. And we even found some new associates, such as they are. Good, I think. Lloyd is getting a read on the place. I think he finds the carpentry very impressive. Andre's been setting up the compressor and dancing. Egghead's been keeping the party up. He's got the stage under control. Sauna, the programmer, she's doing whatever she does behind that radio computer of hers. She doesn't talk to us much, and the crab man hasn't shown himself, thank God. Sure, you helped us out. I can repay the favour. What do you want to know? Andre, he's a cool guy. Doesn't really come off as one, but he is. To me, at least.
She rubs her sides, but not from cold. Her shoulders are relaxed. She must have taken a hit, or she's on an upswing.
He takes care of shit. Sorry. I mean, he's got a vision. For what life should be, you know? He tries to push things until everything falls into place. He's an organiser. Nothing. But then again, there's nothing to organise around here either. He really wants this church thing to work. Must have taken it as a sign when he found it abandoned like that. Said it was an augury. I don't know where he got that from. Andre's not super intelligent. I've never seen him so psyched about anything, though. And he's often psyched. Looks sort of desperate, like it's his last chance or something. Or maybe he was just high. I mean, not that he does drugs, just high, you know. Yes. Anyway. Come to think of it, yes. He's in some kind of a self-destruction mode with that hair of his, bleaching it like that. Probably wants to get rid of it altogether. Yes. Who do you want to know about? Me? Again? I told you, I'm a silver bird.
There's that phrase again. Really reminds you of something.
It means I don't answer questions about myself. Thank you. Sure.
O passaro di agint. It flutters by your ear. It's what the Zemoyaki, the Gradian community in Revershaw, call a person who never breaks under interrogation. It's an organized crime term.
Excuse me?
She's attempting to remain calm, but the phrase made her flinch.
What do you mean? All right. My father was a Zemyaki. He died years ago. He was a bad man. Not a lot of good things to say about him and what he did. He bought the family a huge house, so we got to live, at least temporarily, in a giant castle in Jamrock. And then he died. What do you think? The competition came and took everything away. It was like in a war zone. So after his death, we had nothing left, and we were in danger. My mother had to change her name, mine too. We left it all behind. Yeah, I was kinda hoping you'd end that mess before we got going. It feels like I've been slowly turning dad-wise into a corrupt business person.
She's honest.
A shame you didn't.
The hiss is different from the strings you heard before. It says something else in a lower pitch. Slowly, with your breath held, you take two small steps toward the phasmid. The creature lets out a series of ultrasonic clicks that swarm around your head like swallows. Like laughter, a sort of happiness. The tracheal system on the creature's abdomen expands in front of you to take in and expel air. It's smelling you. Hissing and clicking, it extends its mandible-like antennae to greet you. You're right below it now, looking up at the colossal chitin of its white limbs. The head of the creature is crowned by reeds, and its eyes are like small droplets of water.
Tell me what he's like for you. Fire? Where? I do not have fire inside me. In me, there is not even blood, but limp, like sap from a wine palm. Now, I will tell you what it's like for me. For me, it is a series of half-lit images, a kind of darkness being intruded upon. Transient, dim, moist. Shapes of plants and animals, and internal sensations. A swarm of sounds, tiny vibrations on the inside of my forearms. All speak of complexities totally beyond my understanding. I am at the end of a narrow funnel. Waitress. So light, it only feels like something to be me. In truth, perhaps I'm nothing. I certainly do not have a soul. And if I did, it would never burn. Are you sure? Sometimes, when molting, I regrow a lost limb. One time something went wrong, and a small leg replaced the missing antenna. No, the leg tried to move around independently, making it hard to walk. Yes, thankfully someone ate it. The next time I molded, I grew an antenna again. So am I. I was born to detect sucrose rewards and semiochemicals. What were you born to detect? Yes. No one detected me for such a long, long time. For thousands of years, I dithered out of sight. Trapped myself in greenery. No one believed I exist. Almost no one. Until you came, detective. Dripping of blood that smells like strawberries. Across the calm sea. The first in a thousand.
No, Harry. No. I don't want a massive, epic showdown. I want to go to the aerodrome. I have tickets for the 10:20 flight to Morova. Really. We don't have anything to talk about anymore. Every combination of words has been played out. The atoms don't form us anymore. Us. Our love. Our unborn daughters. It's all gone. I have to go to the aerodrome. I have to leave Revachol and you. And you have to be alone. In hell. Forever. That's just the way it is.
The woman gazes steadily at the waves. A sudden gust picks up her dark hair and lets it fall again. Tussled. Wild. She brushes a few stray locks from her eyes, and only then spots you approaching.
Aye, so here you are. It's late and the sun is going down. It'll be dark soon. If we stay here long enough, we will be joined by a cortege of drunks and teenagers. Know that you're not the first guy to bring a girl to Land's End. This is what the locals call a make-out spot. That is not going to happen here today. I just want to make that clear, Dimples.
There's salt in the air, and the cries of the gulls and the skuas. Grit of the sand and the green glint of broken bottles. But still your gaze always returns to the dazzling streaks of light. Wherever they may be reflected, their fading opulence.
It's bringing us spring, summer. It's entirely on our side. No matter what we do or who we are. For absolutely no reason. I guess we wouldn't really be here if that thing wasn't on our team. Thank you. I'm half Ubi. My mother was from Ubi Sunt. Not a lot of sun there, I hear. Though I've never been.
The wind ruffles her hair as she looks at the setting sun.
It's enough that my fish goes there. 50 real apiece they ask for spring cod.
Here we go. Two different approaches to cap this off with style.
Hi. And a benevolent one. When did you last have one of those on your side? Well, now you have that giant thing to watch over you. So, to hell with youth. You know, the wind's going to pick up soon, and I have to go, but... have this. The sun's good, but it doesn't stick things. I've no use for it anymore.
The graffito has been painted over the traces of the fight that took place here. It smells of blood and heavy fuel oil. This was Cindy the Skull. The lieutenant crouches, touching the fuel oil with his finger.
Looks like it, yes. This is still fresh. It wasn't here yesterday. And blood. Some of it is even yours.
Heavy fuel oil. Isn't that flammable? The fuel oil catches fire immediately with an ominous hiss. A bright orange flash across the surface of the letters. Black smoke rises from the burning message. The lieutenant has taken a small step back. He looks at your face illuminated by the flames and nods silently. Then the fire falters.
Let's go to that island.
Slowly, the flames subside, the fuel burning out. The air still smells of mazout and springtime.
Hey, piss! Look who it is! Shrunken cophead material.
No, no, no. Don't ask anything. Be subtle and scary. The boys dream about being skulls. Use that. Suggest their massive skulls. Come on.
What? No! Skulls don't have kings. I think. And we're not even in yet.
Yeah, man, keep your voice down. Skulls don't take it lightly when folks pretend to be them. We're not even prospects yet.
Prospect? Must be a hierarchical term. Probably in the lower end.
Wow, you boys are ambitious. Only prospects and already planning a coup in the Skulls. You're destined to go far.
He gets it. Passive-aggressive flattery.
Shut the fuck up! Are you trying to get us killed?
Now bring it to the jackets and, yes, start shouting.
Please be quiet. What? What do you want? The jackets?
You got it. No need for cruelty. A shaggy-looking girl in her late teens or early 20s kneels on the ice with an electronic contraption in her hand. Hearing you approach, she looks up.
Oh, hello there.
It's cold out here, but she's not wearing a hat. She must be freezing.
Huh?
Maybe she didn't hear you. A little louder.
So should you. Oh, I didn't notice that. Yeah, well, look, man, fuck the hat.
I'm sorry I said fuck the hat. I was concentrating on something else. My whole family swears and it rubbed off on me. A cell.
Her hair is dyed blonde, with dark roots showing. There's a coarseness to her features, some masculinity below that timidness.
Why? Okay, it's Berger.
A very common name.
This is a portable recording device. It's for field recording. Low quality, but still. Actually, just one wire. I picked on it till the braiding came loose. The wire leads to a contact microphone. Okay. Recording, I guess. I think I'm recording cracks in the ice, but there's no way to tell. Not without headphones. I think I just recorded your footsteps too. Not sure how that will sound.
What happened to the old headphones?
My boyfriend sold them. I don't know, man. Things. Just stuff you need for life.
A lie. They were probably pawned off for something suspicious.
The musicians in the Palaceum used them for making music. They looped the stuff, cutting the tapes together. They make music out of cracks in the ice and keys jangling. Crazy sounds like that. It's hard to explain. Anyway, I thought I'd make some too. It's supposed to be, like, a music place anyway. I don't really know what I'm doing. They use synthesizers too. I don't have a synthesizer.
She looks at the recording device. The thing she thought would fill her hours with joy and escape. It's turning out to be an empty fantasy. She feels childish. Very useless all of a sudden. The sharp drop in endorphins is almost visible. Like a warm blanket has fallen off her shoulders. The wave of chill. The quivering jaw. Indications of a drug high.
Take this, you're cold.
No, man, fuck that, I'm cool. I'm sorry I said that. I'm sorry about the fuck.
It's okay.
Thanks.
The paintbrush in your hand is like a loaded revolver. What will it be, Desperado? Quite a few things come to mind. You've spoken. The wall will now silently repeat the message for a decade or so, until the sea air degrades the paint, adding another layer of detritus to the city.
Very poetic. Real poetry. Should we return to our murder investigation? I hear there's a really bad one we are supposed to solve.
Now the only thing left to do is the name of the club. Will you do the honors, detective?
The name. Everything I managed to come up with sounds just wrong.
Andre's overthinking it.
Yes, you should do it, detective. It would be good for the signs.
Noid's right. You've helped us so much. It's the right thing to do.
I wouldn't. I wouldn't build a club, and I wouldn't name it either.
An underground place with no name? Sounds like something the Crabman would say.
We're not going with anything the Crabman would say.
Why not? The Crabman has ideas, Acel. Ideas from another level of consciousness.
I don't care. I don't like the Crabman, and I don't like his ideas. His ideas are spooky. Next, please.
You have? Well, what's the name?
Like that DeLorean word for the world, you mean? Elysium.
But Disco Elysium? Isn't it wacky? Disco's kind of gone, isn't it?
The past is the future, but the future is dead!
No, it's beautiful. Beautiful and brave, like we want it to be.
And short. And memorable.
It's settled then. Everyone welcome to Disco Elysium.
Andre breaks into frenzied dance-like motion to celebrate the name. Someone turns up the beat. You should go with the flow. Join in on the experience.
I'm dancing!
That soft core gyrating is supposed to be dancing?
Yes, my man!
Talk? What is there to talk about if you can express yourself with moves? You close your eyes and vacate your skull, leaving your brain to wonder, where did that little fluttering light go?
Total darkness.
With your eyes still closed, the first thing you feel, all the way back in the pivoting darkness of your own torso, is warmth. You have become a triumph of rhythmoplastics, somewhere in a smelly wooden church on the coast of Revachol. The wounds from the war you waged on your body are healing, twist by twist, turn by turn. You have become a flawless interlocking mechanism, a flesh and bone approximation of the throb coming from the speaker setup of the one called Eggheads, entirely, rigidly, imbecilic, without pity or fear. Free from self-awareness, no deliberation, only, and I mean only, execution.
Oh my God! No way!
With his reel-to-reel mixer blasting the anthem of a future that will never come, the young man observes your moves for a second. He throws a screwdriver and a bunch of drill chucks into the corner and explodes into dance. What he lacks in sharpness, he more than makes up for in violent enthusiasm. The young man immediately bounces up and down, then assumes the same dance pattern, embellishing it with some sort of waving motion. The authority of the law is clearly unquestionable.
What's going on here? Delinquent.
This is clearly a Code 31 emergency. The lieutenant squeezes the bridge of his nose. The lights reflect off his glasses. He's obviously having trouble adjusting to this new reality.
A Code 31 emergency? Really?
The lieutenant crosses his arms with a bemused look.
What's happening? Good for you. Rock on, then. What?
Who's the one in charge? You are.
Are you kidding me? Get my what on?
Sheesh, okay.
Okay, you psychopath. I see what you're doing there. It's jacked up footwork, plus is that Ubi folk dancing?
Nah, it's not Ubi folk. It's hardcore.
Yeah, whatever.
Oh yeah? I did 15 years in the juvenile crime unit. I can do age inappropriate. Now, check this shit out.
The lieutenant begins to heel kick the church floor with such intensity, it's reasonable to fear he'll kick a hole right through it, causing the floor to crack and the pillars to collapse, bringing the church roof down on all of you. The dynamic motion of your flailing body is bordering on the extreme. You're going off the charts. You feel as if turning on the hyperdrive would be a point of no return. It feels almost melancholy. Are you sure you have the entire posse along for this?
Here we go again! Hardcore fills the air! The sound above my head!
The what now? The sound above your what? Okay, this is too imbecile. Excuse me.
On the coast of the Martinez Inlet, in a small weather-beaten stave church, built 380 years ago by settlers from the Occident, most likely to guard against an anomaly at its center, an officer of the RCM is contorting his body into idiotically rigid shapes as he invents the future of dance music. It's the hardest anyone has ever danced.
I am La Rebachelière. I am the city. I am a fragment of the world spirit, the genius Loki of Rebachel. My heart is the wind corridor. The bottom of my air is red. I have 100,000 luminous arms. Come morning, I carry industrial dust and let it settle on tree leaves. I shake the dust from those leaves and onto your coat. I've seen you. I've seen you. I've seen you with her. And I've seen you without her. I've seen you on the crescent of the hill. The modulations of my voice are noted down with thermometers and barometers. You feel me in your nostrils, on the little hairs on the back of your neck. I also reside in your lungs and vestigial organs. Everywhere there is space. You are an officer of the citizens' militia, Jean Tinrebu. When you wear your coat, you wear my soul. You move through my streets freely in motor carriages and on foot. You have access to the hidden places. You also circulate among those who are hidden. I need you. You can keep me on this earth. Be vigilant. I love you.
I would often go there, to the tiny church there, the smallest church in Sansan, though it once was larger, how the realm may rest there. Down through the mist there, toward the Seven Sisters, toward those pale cliffs there, I would often stay there, in their tiny yard there. I have been so glad here, looking forward to the past here, but now you are all alone. None of this matters. Now, none of this matters at all.
Want to be free. Eternally.
Oh.